actually made a cake that looked exactly like the book. It was incredible. But I guess I shouldn't have been surprised, because Frosted Art Bakery has a reputation for being one of the best bakeries in the Metroplex, serving Dallas, Plano, Frisco, Addison, The Colony, and Southlake. Life is short, and you only get one. Enjoy a slice of Frosted Art today. Find them at frostedart.com. That's frostedart.com.
Did you know there are over 3,000 kinds of snakes? And most, being shy, pose no threat to humans. But they are still feared and killed, even for frivolous fashion. In his poem Snake, D.H. Lawrence marvels at a snake drinking from a water trough. He succumbs to irrational fear and impulsively throws a log at the very animal he admired moments before. He writes, "And immediately I regretted it. I thought how paltry, how vulgar, what a mean act. I despised myself and the voices of my accursed human education, and I wished he would come back, my snake, for he seemed to me again like a king in exile, uncrowned in the underworld." This is Ingrid Newkirk with Peter, reminding us it's easy to be kind by choosing fake snake over real skin for belts, bags, and shoes.
Show. It's George Clinton and the Funkadelics. Oh my gosh. Yeah, you know, I was thinking we should play one song so everybody can, I don't know which one, I'll pick it like during the break and we'll just play the whole song. So during this hour that we're live on the air, everybody can pull over and just, I was dancing in my car because I couldn't get enough of it. It was like a drug for me.
Yeah.
Once you get me rolling on that, like it's hard for me to come down off it. And I was thinking, I'm addicted to music too. I'm an addict. I'm addicted to everything. I just like to mix.
Not a bad thing to be addicted to if you have to choose a vice, right?
Yeah, I guess. So that's a good one, right?
Right.
That's a good habit.
Sure.
Oh, my gosh. Well, everyone, welcome back to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray, DeWone Bennett, and Jill Lane. DeWone is a licensed professional counselor with over 11 years of counseling experience from Vallejo, California. And Jill Lane is a pro athlete health and nutrition coach and founder of Fueling Champions, which is a three-step sports performance and athletic nutrition program built to maximize the potential of student athletes and the parents that support them. You can find Jill on Instagram at Team Fueling Champions or her website fuelingchampions.org. And DeWone, I don't see your email on this outline. So what, or not your email, sorry, I didn't mean to put your email out there, but your social media. Where can people find you?
You can find me at DeWone Bennett Counseling on Facebook, and you can also email me at counseling@dewonebennett.com.
There you go. Yeah. So the food, you know, that we're talking about here, microbiome, all the stuff that we've been talking about is both body and mind. They're connected. So
sure.
I love the fact that we have a shrink here,
yes,
and a nutritionist, so we can really get to the heart of the matter on some of these things that, no pun intended, matter so much to our overall health and well-being. So, Jill, I know we were going to talk about the bugs within your gut microbiome, and then, of course, this little article that we pulled out of, where'd we pull this out of? Shape Magazine. It's another one that's got all the drug pharmaceutical company ads in it, too. They're probably produced by the same company. I bet they are. I need to know.
Who knows?
I bet they are.
You know. Beware of what you read. We always talk about that.
Oh my gosh.
Read stuff, but do your homework.
Yeah, absolutely. But a lot of people don't have time to do their homework.
You're right.
So, you know, they easily get persuaded to believe something that's not fact, you know, like that saturated fat is bad for you, like mm-hmm. coconut oil or avocados or these things that are rich in really high quality fats. It's not bad for you. But you know, this article from the Food Lab, Why Am I Always Hungry? It says you eat, but then an hour later, your stomach is screaming. Here is what's going on. And How to Stay Satisfied by Maureen Soman Schwartz. Okay, so what do you think about this article? You looked it over,
mm-hmm.
and what do you have to say?
Well, I think it's really interesting. It talks a lot about in the opening. I'll give a shout out to my alma mater because the woman in the opening comments is a professor of human nutrition and exercise science at the University of Wyoming. And she talks about the fact that hunger comes from a variety of different sources. And we talk about that. Sometimes you're thirsty,
mm-hmm.
but it masquerades as hunger. Sometimes you're stressed. Sometimes you're tired. But the body is like, okay, she or he's not stopping. She must need more energy. So mm-hmm. I'm going to tell him or her she's hungry,
yeah.
or he's hungry to get more energy. And so we have to assess through that. And they talk a little bit about this, but they actually transition to the salt in your diet.
Yeah.
And at the first take, because you and I are avid, I think, avid fans of people using the right kind of salt. And so when you first read this and go, what? They're saying you can't eat salt? It's actually not about that. It has to do with what we were talking about before the break. It's that the junk and the processed food, the
right.
salt and the processed food, the combination of that chemical makeup drives your desire to overeat.
Well, yeah, and the type of salt is very important because I personally use real salt. I've used it for years. It's mined here in Utah, I believe, but it's loaded full of minerals,
right.
and your brain and your body need minerals. It's not just, you know, table salt, cheap table salt. This is a salt that's really, really good for you. So I made homemade dressing last night, just olive oil and balsamic vinegar, nothing fancy. And I just put a little bit of, you know, the real salt, the sea salt, in there just a little tiny bit to give it a little, you know, a little bit of a salty bite, if you will. No pun intended again. And it makes the food so much better and healthier if it's the right kind of salt, correct?
Yeah, no, it matters. I mean, the average table salt is just sodium chloride, but real salt, salt that you mine, the stuff that comes out of the salt mines, is not just sodium. It's loads of other trace minerals, stuff that we can't even probably detect and know that's there as of yet.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, again, back to just kind of eating from nature. And so the deal with salt is that we should be buying stuff that's unsalted, but then putting complex Himalayan or mined mm-hmm. salt that's not just sodium, because when we think of salt, we only think of sodium, but
right.
salt has other minerals in it. And adding that to our food, because electrolytes, salt is an electrolyte, and electrolytes are what make our muscles contract and relax amongst a variety of other things in our body. And so we need electrolytes. Salt's gotten such a bad rap because of hypertension and heart disease. And there may be some, and I say this, you know, because of the DASH diet and some of the other things that have come out from our government, there may be some data to show in some instances that people truly do have a salt sensitivity,
mm-hmm.
but they say only 5% of people with hypertension, which is high blood pressure, have a salt sensitivity. So it's not the salt in their diet. It's the junk food and the fact that they're not taking care of themselves.
And the lack of exercise.
That's right.
Because when when you're not relaxed and you're not feeling well, your blood pressure does get high.
Yeah, listen, don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. They say, okay, junk food, okay, it has salt in it. Yeah, that's right. So throw away the junk food, but get some real salt and put it on fresh, you know, vegetables that you make. Put a little bit on your chicken breast to season it,
mm-hmm.
along with other herbs and spices. Don't be afraid of using, I say real salt. You think of just like the Morton salt you buy over the counter, but, you know, something that's like a Himalayan salt, a mined salt that's not just, you know, sodium chloride. It needs to have iodine in it too, which
mm-hmm.
is mostly stripped out of most salts, which is super important for your thyroid. So we just need to have the stuff that's close to what it comes out of nature.
Well, is it true? It says here that salt is stoking your appetite. Yes, it makes you thirsty in the short term, but over time, high intake of salt actually causes you to drink less but eat more.
Yeah, and I don't know the details of the study. If it's anything like that processed food study we were just talking about, I want to be like, well, what were they eating? Were they eating these Ruffles baked potato salty things? Because if that's the case, it wasn't just the salt
mm-hmm.
that was causing them the problem. It was the MSG and the other chemicals in the food. Or were they eating broccoli with a little of natural sea salt on it? I doubt that's what they were eating in this research study, because that's not what they feed people usually in research studies when they're, you know, looking at things like this. So when they say people on a high salt diet, to me, that means they're eating processed food, which is not just the salt's fault.
Right.
It's the rest of the chemicals in the processed food.
Right. Well, the
food.
Chemicals, point being, you know, this bag of Ruffles baked potato chips. 65,
but they're baked.
They're baked.
So
oh, that means
you.
They're healthy. Cheddar and sour cream. But it says, so there's Yellow 5 Lake and Yellow 5 and Yellow 6.
Mm.
These are all artificial colorings. And there's maltodextrin, which spikes your blood sugar twice that of table sugar. I mean, all these things, cornstarch, does it get any worse? Or corn oil, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
all genetically modified. Yeah. I mean, they've proven in studies and research that genetically modified foods make mice obese.
Right.
So why do we think that this isn't, that, you know, foods like this are not affecting our health? It's crazy.
Yeah. I mean, and for those listening, just because it says baked on it doesn't mean it's better for you.
Right.
You know, I think that's, unfortunately, still people must still be buying into that, or else they wouldn't be still
selling
a product like this.
Yeah.
And so it's not better. I would rather buy like avocado oil potato chips, which I do at my house, you know, mm-hmm. an oil that doesn't go rancid, that's from non-GMO potatoes or non-GMO corn chips, and just know what you're getting out of it instead yeah. of thinking you're making a healthier choice mm-hmm. just because it says baked.
Well, it says here that when you start the day with starchy, quick-digesting carbs like cereal, waffles, or toast, you wake up your hunger hormones and make them more active all day.
Oh, gosh. From an RD.
From an RD.
Not surprising.
Yeah. Registered Yeah. That's because these foods can cause your blood sugar to spike, blah, 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 blah.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. Yeah, no, I have a strong opinion opposite of that. I mean, you don't want to – who wants to wake up their hunger hormones? You want to wake up and rev up your metabolism, which
right.
raising insulin does not do. As soon as your insulin is elevated, fat cannot come out to be burned for fuel. And so if you're trying to maintain a healthy body composition, keep your cholesterol healthy, manage inflammation, you do not want – elevated or spiked insulin multiple times throughout the day. Mm-hmm. That's a recipe for diabetes and
right.
all sorts of other things.
Right.
So that is not, quote unquote, from this article, waking up. You don't want your hunger hormones
yep.
woken up. You want to be satiated and
right.
full because you've put together the right macronutrient blend, and that's telling your body to burn fat for fuel and dabble with a little bit of sugar that you might be coming in. But that is just such unfortunate information to be in such a major publication.
No, I agree. That's why these things, they make me crazy. And they send them to me for free. I get almost every single magazine out there. This type of magazine, not a lot of other good quality ones. But so we're going to talk more about this when we come back from break. And so everyone stay tuned. You're listening to Jill Lane, DeWone Bennett, and Bernadette. And we're going to go to break.
Hello, I'm Allie McGraw for People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. Our animal companions rely on us, especially during a natural disaster. If you're forced to evacuate your home, do not leave your animals behind. Visit helpinganimals.com.
Did you know that the U.S. Department of Health actually patented cannabinoids as antioxidants and neuroprotectants? So clearly there is promise for CBD to help with a variety of issues. H-Hemp's U.S.-grown CBD system is fully tested for purity and safety. For daily balance, H-Hemp has the best-tasting CBD tinctures available. Their Super Breath Blast delivers near-immediate relief and relaxation while on the go. And the Magic Balm works wonders for your muscles, joints, and temples. Relax and feel better naturally with the H-Hemp CBD system from hhemp.com.
If you haven't heard, I'm always searching for ways to supplement magnesium. Magnesium is a vital mineral that enhances your natural cellular and electrical impulses to help you sleep better, smooth your muscles, and improve heart and brain health. Magnesium also helps you to become mentally and physically stronger and resilient to illness. Sun Warrior's Ionic Magnesium Complex is sourced from a non-GMO island seabed, concentrated by the sun and harvested naturally without the use of chemicals or solvents. We like to refer to it as yoga in a bottle. So pick up yours today at sunwarrior.com. That's sunwarrior.com.
Hi, I'm Bob Barker. This is my friend Benny. Before you buy cosmetics, personal care, or household products, you be sure they have not been tested on animals. Everything from floor cleaner to shampoo is poured into animals' eyes and down their throats. They suffer intensely. Some even go blind. The price is never right for products tested on animals. Visit PETA.org for a list of cruelty-free companies.
This is Jill with the One Life Radio Fueling Champions Minute. Did you know magnesium is a cofactor in more than 300 enzyme systems that regulate diverse biochemical reactions in the body, including protein synthesis, muscle and nerve function, blood glucose control, and blood pressure? Magnesium is required for energy production, oxidative phosphorylation, and glycolysis. That's a mouthful. How do you know if you're getting enough? Signs and symptoms of possible magnesium deficiency include restless leg syndrome, agitation, insomnia, muscle stiffness, cramping, and aches. Well, where do you find magnesium? Food sources include raw almonds, leafy greens like cooked spinach and chard, raw cashews, pumpkin seeds, black beans, avocados, and my favorite, dark chocolate. Don't forget those Epsom salt baths and be smart about supplementation. This has been the One Life Radio Fueling Champions Minute.
Hi, this is Sean Wells, certified sports nutritionist, registered dietitian, and biochemist. One Life Radio and I are so excited about the launch of our Thorne dispensary. Thorn is the most used brand by medical practitioners as a result of its industry-leading quality control. Further, Thorn has a team of doctors, chemists, and dietitians formulating their products to be the gold standard. There are very few products I would personally endorse as a clinician, nutritional biochemist, and the world's greatest formulator, but Thorn is atop my short list. Visit OneLifeRadio.com to shop my hand-selected vitamin